What's up, guys? It's your boy Prince. How's it been doing, guys? Guys, lately, I gotta tell the truth, I've been procrastinating, but let's not worry about that. Today, we're gonna be doing something special, guys, something really special. Today, we are done with that little hat over there. It's gone. It's bye-bye now. I hate it. Today, we're gonna be doing something special. We're gonna be making our very own starter house, and I'll be teaching you ways of how you can do that. Okay, so guys, today I said we're gonna be doing something special, right? Today we're gonna be making our very own starter house. And for those who do not know, of course everybody else knows, it's just a house that you build at the starting of the game. Okay, it seems like it's about to get dark. Okay, today I'm gonna be giving you some tips of ways you can actually build better. And I have went out of my way to get the materials that I will need right in this chest. Yeah, it's a lot, but then what we're gonna be doing today is gonna be worth it. Okay, I wonder if I can still do what I wanna do while the sun is going down. Okay, so first tip of building better is the idea phase. Like, what do you want your build to look like? Like, what do you want it to represent? Like, do you want it to look like modern? Do you want it to look like rustic, suburban? Or do you just want to look, make it look like something out of this world? Okay, so you see, if you can't think of your own ideas, what you could do is you could just go like on the internet, or you can go on like YouTube. You can like look at tutorials of how to build. Like, every person has had to go through that phase before, even me. Okay, I hate it when this happens. Okay, I really hate it when this happens. Come on, sleep. Okay, as I was saying, if you can't get an idea, what you could do is you can just go to YouTube, watch your favorite YouTuber, and like learn a thing or two. That can really help you and can really like save some time, like, so you won't get too frustrated, you know what I mean? Okay, second step of building is the build palettes. So what is a build palette? A build palette is just a fancy way for saying this. What blocks you're gonna be using. So for today, the block palette that I wanna use is stone, oak wood, spruce, and this is what is this, acacia? No, this ain't acacia. It's yeah, I just want to use this one. Like, okay, so thingy, if you're not good at choosing block palettes, what you could do is just experiment and see what goes well for you and what you could do. Okay, so now that we've got the idea and the block palette out of the way, it's time for the outline. So, in its own name, you know what outline means. Like, ah, man, I just lost a block. Okay, so in its own name, outline technically just means like making the outline. Like, what do you like with the shape of the building? Like, what do you want it to make it? What do you want to make it look like? So the outline that I'm gonna be using, I think I might have to remove this house because it might get into the in my way. Okay, so what am I gonna be doing? My outline is gonna be 5 blocks. This is 4, right? Yep, this is 4. 5. Oak. So, guys, this is the outline of the build that I'm going to be making today. Today, I won't be making a big house. I'm not going to be making a big house, guys. I'm just going to make, like, a simple small house, which has space and is simple. I don't want it to be too fancy. But I wanted to have quite a lot of detail. And I definitely wanted to be better than this. Yeah. Okay, for now, I don't have scaffolding. I do have bamboo, but I don't have... Oh, now what's it called? String. And it is something that I really desire right now. Okay, so now that we have gotten outline out of the way, it's time for the third step, which is build. And build... technically has more steps in it, but build is technically building the actual thing. So let's start off with the frame. So the frame is like something like this, like, let's say, getting the idea of what you want your house to look like. Okay, I'm just gonna start like a time lapsing this because I can't really focus on building while talking at the same time, but I will occasionally stop and give some like words of advice. Guys, so now we've gotten pretty much the lower frame. Now it's time to actually I actually didn't explain what a frame is, so let me just explain what the frame is. So the frame is pretty much this, like getting the design of what you want your house to be like. It's like making a shell, like, and until you start filling things inside of it. So right now I'm working on the shell, on the lower half of the shell, because I don't know if people consider a roof as I wonder if they actually consider it as, what's it called, if they consider it as a, okay, now I'm just spitballing here. I forgot what I wanted to say. Okay guys, forgive me. Okay, so another thing that I want to add right now, I shouldn't be adding it right now, but it's just that I want to add it right now so I don't end up forgetting. It's a porch, which is part of detailing, and I shouldn't be adding it right now, but like, what the heck. I mean, I can do what I want to do, right? It's a free world, right guys? It's a free world. Okay. So I don't know if this is called like a porch or a front courtyard, but this is what I want to add, guys. Okay, back to what I was saying, guys. I just added that for like, so I don't forget about it. Okay, so how do I get back up here? I think I'll just do this. I technically wasn't finished with the thing that's called the frame. It was just that I had to explain something about frames. But either way, let me just do this. And I just remember that I forgot to tell you another important part about building depth. Okay guys, yes, Sfundo just pranked call me, and I answered, and yeah, I've just been pranked. Okay, so where was I remember talking about not being, I haven't finished. Oh, depth, yeah, that's what it was. So depth is, it's a type of detail. I know I shouldn't be adding this right now, but I mean, like, what the heck, I can do it right now. So this thing, what is a depth? It's technically the art of making your build pop in and out like this. Can you see like the wood, how it's outside and then the build is like inside at the same time? That's like, that's a type. Oh no, I shouldn't have added that. Wasn't, ah, okay, either way, what was I saying about depth? it's technically making your build pop in and out. And that's an important thing in building, but you mustn't overdo it, because if you overdo it, then yeah, it's gonna look like, what, this person, no, he did too much. So let me get back to finishing off this part of the build. So guys, I now think I'm actually done with the lower half of the framing. I'm just trying to, okay, bees. I'm just trying to like get a look and see if there's anything wrong. But you can see what I did there with the depth. You see, like it makes it look like the house is being supported by the wood. Okay, now I think it's time to actually add the floor, because I kind of forgot to do that. But then, I was working on something else, and this is a problem already. Okay, so I think the flow is okay now. So I think now it's around about time to add the second floor, and I forgot to make more. You know, at this rate, I think I'm actually gonna run out of oak, cause this somehow I made the wrong calculation and I'm paying the price for it. So I think here would be a good place to put the stairs for the next floor. Okay, 1, 2. Okay guys, I think I'm actually done with the flooring for the second roof. Whoa, that was such bad English. I meant to say that I think I'm actually done with the flooring for the second floor now, and I just realized that I'm actually not done. Yep, now I am not done, and I'm guessing here. Wait, here, cool, here, cool. Okay, so that's cool. Now I'm done with the flooring. Now what I need to do, and one of the most painful things ever is make the roof. So for the roof, I'm gonna go with spruce, because you know, I kind of went with a lot of I went with a lot of oak, then I went with a lot of that, and then that, and then that. You get what I mean? You can't just carry on going with the same thing, you know. Life requires change, and if you don't change, then what's the point, man? You understand what I'm saying? Okay, I feel like I'm becoming delirious here. Okay, back to the point. So for the roof, if I haven't mentioned yet, roof is one of the most annoying things ever. Well, for me, of course. And also in this part, if you're going to be building the same house, I advise you to start by putting torches like this, because you don't want a creeper spawning in here, like, for now, like, while you're still busy making the other things. Once you finish with the roof and everything else, that's when you can start, like, reorganizing here, and then you can remove the torches and put some stuff in there to minimize mob spawns. Okay, for the roof, this is gonna be harder since I'm in survival and not creative, and there's a chance that I could actually fall off multiple times. Like, that is annoying. Okay, so how am I gonna do this? Okay, crouch, and yes, I actually did it. Oh, I almost fell off. And that's what I'm talking about. That is annoying. Okay, you know what? What I can do. And all of it has been used up. Okay, you know what I can still do? Bam, now I got myself a shovel. So it's a good time to mention that when it comes to roofs, I am not a pro in that. That's a disclaimer for all of y'all. I am not a pro when it comes to roofs. So I would say either search up Green or Waddles. They are really good at building, and like you can search how to do roofs and stuff like that. But my opinion when it comes to roofs, it's go with the flow, man. Just joking. I honestly don't have really good tips for roofs. Okay, besides the go with the flow, that I'm actually serious about. Go with the flow. Okay, so I think I should just get back up there. I guess it's a good time to actually just use the spade in the house now, because I mean, it's not finished, but it is working and stuff. Okay, this is really bad. It's gotten quite dark. Okay, I'm awake. So for the next episode, I'm not ending this one right now. I'm just like saying, like, for the next episode, I'll give you a sneak peek. Okay, just a narrow sneak peek. But I'll just be like, I'll give you a hint. It has something to do with something shiny. Something shiny and very valuable. That is my tip. My hint, I mean. If you can figure that out, you're a genius. And you'll be a very rich genius. And back to the time lapse. So guys, sorry for the interruption, but then it's just that I ran out of wood. Yes, I ran out of wood. And I just realized that my sheep are gone. If you remember from the past episode, there was sheep there. I don't know how they disappeared. Okay, so this thing, what is it? I'm gonna just get back to this thing, because I felt it was important to say my sheep are gone, because they means a lot to me. So guys, I now finished the roof, and I went ahead and removed all the dirt scaffolding so I can show you get you the feeling of what the build looks like. Now it's time for style. Now style, it's like detail but not adding detail at the same thing. Style is like adding windows. Like I didn't want to put windows yet because I was gonna do that in style. So, style is like adding windows, adding type of shapes to your building, but that can also be detail. You know, sometimes I feel like style and detail are the same thing, but it's hard to differentiate between them. So, style, right now I'm going to be adding windows and this thing, or is it? For style, I think that's what I can only do, like add windows to the building, and I feel like I don't have enough windows. On top of that, guys, now I'm actually done with the windows, and I would say it's time for the detailing step, but then, like, I really don't want to add too, in fact, I don't want to add any detail to this one. I feel like it's okay as it is right now, because too much detail makes a building look bad. But what I can tell you about detail, so details like adding those little things in life, like this small courtyard right here, this is detail, because not most houses would have it. That way it makes it more personalized. And detail is also making the door like in the outside, and also having some thingy, the different variants in stone. Like if I were to be using cobblestone, that one that's like cracked, I would have like the mossy cobblestone, the one that like looks green. But either way, as I was saying, I don't think I have that much detail to tell you here. But maybe like adding oak wood in the middle of this. But then it's just that since this is my first house, I really don't want to mess with it too much. So I'm just going to leave it at that. Guys, I'm not sure if I've actually shown you this before. I think I have. I think it was in episode 2. I still feel like I haven't shown you this before, but let's not focus on that. Okay, so the thing is, for this next step, it's not compulsory, but it is if you really want to make your house look good. So I went ahead and removed the dirt house because it was in the way. So right now it's time to terraform. And if you do not know what terraforming is, it's technically building the land or fixing the land, because I mean, look at this. You see this hill right here. It's not good looking. It doesn't go with the house. It's just not good, and plus it gives it an uneven height. So I'm just gonna go ahead and remove this hill. Okay, so guys, I've removed the hill. So another thing about terraforming, try to make it look natural. Like, let's say you remove a mountain, try to make it look like it's still a small hill or something like that. Don't make it completely flat, because someone's definitely gonna know, like, oh man, something's wrong there, what's up? So try to keep things as natural as possible, because natural is good sometimes, you know, like it really makes a build look good. So right now I'm just gonna like remove this and try to keep it as natural as possible, because as I say before, natural is good, and I'm not speaking about that at the hippie's point of view. Okay, I think this should be okay for now. Okay, now that you have actually gotten the look of what you want your land to look like, it's actually time to like add stuff like flowers. And this thing, or is it, those can make your house really look good. So this part of my thingy, the base, has already set up some things I would like to use for flowers. And I think I'll use maybe these two. Now I just wonder if I can actually place this thing. I don't know how these things work. I think you can use a fence post. Nope, can't use a fence post. You know what, I'm just gonna skip ahead of this one and like try to find a way of using this. So guys, I found out how you can actually place the potted plants, but I like this one here, but I'm not so sure about this one, so I might end up removing this one later. But let me also show you another trick you can do, and that requires trapdoors. And do I have any? It doesn't look like it. Do I have any wood? It doesn't look like it. Okay, I got the wood and trapdoors. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. I think I now have 10. Okay, so that'll require that, and also this. If you wanna, I'm not sure if either way, just use any type of dirt that's not weird looking. And I guess I'll use these flowers. And nope, just these flowers. Okay. I think it should be placed somewhere right here. Now, where are my trap doors? That's gonna take forever, and I don't have my axe. Come on, just radio on. I'm not singing, just know that, yeah. Okay. That's cool. That's pretty good. And time to actually put some bushes. And a good trick that you can use to make bushes, like, I mean, grass in Minecraft is, how should I say this without being mean? It's terrible. Unless you're trying to go for like a wildish look, like something that's not tamed or anything like that. But another way you can go about it, like an alternative for grass in Minecraft, is leaves. You can actually use leaves to make grass. And also, there's this pumpkin trick I want to show you that's good for like making lights without using torches. Let's say like you're in the dark. Okay, 1, 2. Okay, so as I was saying, bushes in Minecraft. This is a good trick if you really wanna make your house look good. Is you can do this. Now, where is this jack-o'-lantern? These could be used as a light source. You might have seen one at the top of the staircase thing there, or bridge, staircase, whatever you call it. Try to make it look random. So this would be what a bush would look like. And try to make them look random. Don't make them look like actual shapes. And don't put them too close to each other, or things can get weird. And I forgot about the jack-o'-lanterns. It's just that I most likely won't be out here at nights most of the time, so I really don't need to put it. But then I have an issue when it comes to mobs. I really do not like any hostile mobs in by my house. And if you do not know what that means, it just means the bad guys. You do not want the bad guys near your place. So I think it's good to light up your place once in a while, especially if it's a village, because you really want to keep your villagers safe. Yeah, I think I put enough bushes. Yeah, that should be enough. And one more. And another one. Yeah, that should be enough. And then I should continue off with the flowers. I would put like a little pond, but then problem is, the thing is that I don't have a bucket, and you need iron for that. So I have decided that in the next episode, we're gonna be finding a lot of iron and a lot of shiny things, if you know what I'm talking about. Okay, when you're using tall, oh right, they follow me when I'm holding flowers. So as I was saying, when you're using tall flowers, try not to put them too close to each other. Maybe like distance them a bit, and then try not to use the same color a lot. Use colors that complement each other a lot, like, you know, white and red. Or okay, so I never really did well on this part of the subject when it came to school, when it was primary colors and those type of colors. I really do not know which colors go well together. Okay, I'm just gonna go with trial and error here. I'm just gonna press them like randomly. And I think I don't have enough colors. Yeah, I think that shall do. That shall actually do, except pathway. I mean, what's a house without a really good pathway? And when it comes to a pathway, try not to make it too connected, or it'll look like it's actually going somewhere, in case your pathway isn't going anywhere. And then try to come in with stones. I mean, like, put things that look like stone. Let's say like this. It looks like a really flat stone. Or what you can do is use a button. And I don't know why this thing is still so far up. So far, this thing, where is it? When it comes to interior, I don't think I'm gonna be doing that much. This thing, where is it? I won't be doing any interior like in front of you guys. I'll do that off camera, because I honestly don't know much about interior decorating, so I will just like leave it to the pros. And yeah, to the pros, you just keep doing what you're doing. And unless you guys really like the thingy, the design I'm gonna do for the interior, I will show you. But for now, I just don't know what to do with interior here. Okay, so as I was saying about the pathway, I think the pathway is actually taking my time here. Okay, that stone there, that's actually a big stone. Okay, for now, because I really don't want to end up messing up the place too much, I think this shall be it. And I really like it if you guys like rated this house like out of a like 10, like, and also the decoration outside like out of 10, like, please give me some feedback, because I really want to know, because this house, the roof was annoying, but it was still fun doing it, and also tricky. Yeah, but I think that's it for today, so have a nice one, guys.